Hey y'all, I'm back. Finally. Had to take a break because I've been kind of going through it out in these museum streets, man. Ain't no joke. But back today to share a little art and a little light since times are so crazy. And I wanted to follow up on my last video where me and Justin Brown are chopping it up about his work. And I mentioned the American landscape painter, Robert Selden Duncanson. So I wanted to give you guys a first person sort of point of view look at the Duncanson that we have in the collection here at IMA. So this is one of our jewels of our Hudson River School collection here in Newfields. It's entitled Long Lock. It was inspired by Duncanson's visit to Scotland during the Civil War years. And I wanted to give you guys the point of view look at it to encourage you that when you're looking at a 2D paint or looking at a painting, walk around it so you can really see the depth that the artist, you know, put into it. He painted our painting as well as the painting that you see right now, which is housed in Smithsonian's American collection. Smithsonian's painting shares the same title as our painting, and they were both completed in 1876 when Duncanson returned to the States after the Civil War. So Duncanson is a very, very important figure. He's one of the first African-American artists to gain international acclaim for his work. He's the only Black Hudson River School painter. Mixed race individual, clearly. Mom was African-American, dad was a Scottish-Canadian. Born and raised in New York, and then he relocated himself, you know, to the Midwest to study painting, particularly in Cincinnati. He worked as an itinerant painter as well as a photographer for a number of years, you know, just to kind of keep the bills paid. And for all my Detroit players out there, he worked in Detroit for a very long time. So if you get a chance, because I'm just gonna claim it on life when we're actually able to kind of go out again, you know, go to the DIA and see their holdings of Duncanson's, because they really have a deep holding of Duncanson's work. So he starts painting in the 1840s, and by the end of the 1840s, 1848 to about 1850, he's getting a lot of attention, right? People are starting to buy his work, commission his work, and he's commissioned by Nicholas Longworth, who's a prominent Cincinnati businessman, prominent abolitionist, and he commissions Duncanson to paint this series of murals in the front entrance of his home. And this residence is now most popularly known as the Taft Museum of Art. So again, I'm just going to claim on life that we'll be able to travel by the summer. So if you're in the Cincinnati area in the summer, definitely check out the murals and check out the exhibition A Splendid Century, which will feature Long Lock, the painting from the IMA. So to get back to our painting, you know, this view gives you a real close up to the detail. You know, as Duncanson painted, he always left a little bit of painting, of paint kind of raised up from the canvas when he created the detail and the figures, in a lot of his work, and that's called impasto. Look at just the detail of the rocks, and like, this is an everyday, you know, scene, right? Of people just kind of coming down to the lock, you know, enjoying themselves for respite, fishing, you know, just the day-to-day, right, you know, of the people of Scotland. So again, when you're in museums and you're looking at landscape paintings, you know, get as close as you can without damaging the painting or without touching the canvas, you know, to see the details, to see the way in which artists use perspective and, you know, foreground and, like I said, the color and line, right, to create the depth. Step back, right, even pull yourself away, you know, from the painting so that you can see the way that they use light and the way that they depict light to really produce the majesty, again, of the American landscape.